Okay, guys. So now last time we took a quick look at BodyCommerce and the different areas within it and the different spaces where you'll find different settings to achieve different things, as well as kind of a quick look at the different modules and how they interact with each other and where you should be using them. Now we're getting into the thick of it where we're going to start displaying our products on the front end of the site using BodyCommerce and no longer those base Divi modules. And if I haven't said it before, I'm going to say it again. This ain't no design course. We are working on functionality and implementing BodyCommerce into your Divi e-commerce stores. So luckily, Elegant Themes has a free layout pack called Clothing Store. And we're going to be using this one kind of as our base, and then we're going to be enhancing it with BodyCommerce. So let's jump back to the back end of our Divi site here. And what we'll do is we're going to go over to the Divi library. Now, in the previous lessons, we did take a look at this shop page layout that we created, but we didn't do anything with it, but now we will. So I'm going to go hit edit. All right. So we have the option to choose a pre-made layout. Of course, that's what we're doing. And then all we need to do is kind of narrow it down. Of course, this is a clothing store, so it's going to be within fashion and beauty. And here it is, clothing store. So we'll click on that. Now, remember I said we are interested in the homepage layout. So let's go ahead and click on that one. And then we'll just go ahead and say use this layout, and it'll do the little importing bit and hopefully single load, not classic Divi double load. Okay, there we go. So we can go into the visual builder view here, and we can kind of see all the stuff that adds to the page. And here it's actually already pulling in our products that we've added. So that is pretty handy, but this is the part that we're going to be working with right now. So what we're going to do, I want you to delete this one, and then we're going to hit the plus button because that one was using the base Divi shop module. Now in here, you can either scroll down to BodyCommerce, and then over here, you will keep going down until you find the ARP product loop module. Or of course, you probably already know, you can type in product loop here, and then it'll also pull up the module that you're looking for. But this is the one that we're interested in. It's the one that displays our products on the page, and you'll see, oh, well, we don't have a layout selected yet. Yep, this is one of the features in Divi BodyCommerce where you can completely customize what these pages look like. Now, we're not going to be covering the product loop layout itself. We're going to do that in a lesson that's going to be coming up. But luckily, BodyCommerce is a nice and easy way to get you rolling in there, and it's called loop templates. Now, what loop templates are, they're just basically pre-made layouts that we've coded for you that will display your products on the page. Now, let's take a quick little look here at some of the settings in this product loop module, which is also, you know, technically considered an archive page. You can disable certain, you know, categories and products when they have, you know, specific categories or whatnot, or child categories. You can control how it loads more products. Now, here is the animation it would do for that. And of course, we do that with Ajax, or you can do just normal pagination. That's going to be up to you. We're going to come down here to the loop options. Now, you can kind of control what is displayed. Now, if you wanted to exclude certain products from this shop layout, you can go ahead and do so. You can include only certain taxonomy. You can exclude certain taxonomies. And then, of course, you can just also load these terms when the page loads only. That will just affect the way that the products filter. Now, more on that in the documentation, of course, at help.divienginegine.com. Now, in loop layout options, this is going to say how many posts we want to show. I think I'm good with 9. So let's only show 9 products in this loop. And now you'll see that it still shows more than 9, but that is probably just a visual builder bug. So I'm not going to worry about that. And yeah, you can also go ahead and include certain terms. We will go down to element. Now, here you can say that you want to show the default order by menu. And what that does actually, it just adds a little icon at the top here, which is going to show you, you know, do you want to sort by popularity, that type of stuff. But we are not going to be using that, as in a later lesson, we're going to be adding some custom order by or sorting options. So I'm going to switch that one off. And then here we have the option to choose how we load more products on the page. So right now it's set to pagination, which, as you would know, is the little 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, whatever at the bottom of the page. I want to use one of Divi Engine's fun features, which is going to be infinite scroll. So you just keep scrolling and scrolling and scrolling, and the products will load. And that is one of the cool things that we can do. Now, in retrospect, I'm not going to do that on this page, as this is going to be on the home page. So maybe we'll rather have that on a filter page. So maybe when we have a specific store page that we'll do in a little bit, where we're just going to copy this layout, but that will be later when we've built a custom loop layout and all that fun stuff. So let's just go ahead and put this as none. We just want to show the first 9 products. Now, you've also got grid options here, and you can select your grid style. You can go with list. You can go with the list grid switcher, which is another awesome feature of BodyCommerce. Or you can go with the masonry. That's going to be entirely up to you. That is for you to decide. Now, you decide how many columns you want on the different screen sizes, and you can also adjust custom gutter gaps. Now, this is kind of useful when you're using one of the loop templates, but when you get into building out your own custom loops, you have a little bit more control over that spacing, but we'll look at that a little bit later. Now, grid list view options. We're not using that now, but we will be using that later, so I'm not going to cover that right now. Loop template options. So now, since we selected a loop template, here we get to show an excerpt, for example, of the product, and you can add and remove. You can remove the add to cart button. Now, bear in mind, like all these features are not visual builder compatible, so you will not see that necessarily on the back end, but you will on the front end. And you guys know the drill. These will show the variations and all the other fun stuff that is in there. All of your design settings, of course, are going to live over here. That's going to be up to you, how you style these. You can see here, there's one specific for the loop template. Just note that when you come here to the loop template section, you want to go to the WooCommerce one, because that's the one that's going to control this particular layout. But there are some common settings here in the general where you can change the padding, you can change the fonts, you can do all sorts of fun stuff. You know, you can make the title bigger. And you see, some of the settings do work in the visual builder, just some of them do not, as we're waiting for that Divi 5 to drop so that we can make everything nice and compatible with that. So we've built out our beautiful shop area here with the archive loop module. How do we display it on the front end? Well, the first step's going to be, of course, is to save this layout. And then remember earlier when we went through the BodyCommerce overview, I showed you some of the settings areas. Now we're going to go over to Divi Engine BodyCommerce. And then remember I told you that we've got all these different pages and areas where you can send the user and interactions with the user. This, of course, is a shop page because we have designated as such. And here you can select the shop template. Now, I am going to go ahead and select that layout that we created. This is the layout that we just worked on. And if we just go on the front end here and we refresh our root domain, you see that we've still got this layout right here. But as soon as I save this one, now you can also assign layouts per categories and all that fun stuff. We're not digging into that as we kind of lay down the foundation here. Okay, so we're on the front end again. Let's refresh. We don't need to go anywhere else, but now you can see that that layout's been applied to our homepage. And here are all of our products. Only 9, as I said, would be. And that is that. That is how you display products on the front end using the archive loop module. Now, of course, I told you guys we're going to be covering building out a custom loop template also, which will just give you a lot more flexibility as far as what you'll see here on this part of the screen. So let's get ready and go on to the next step.